Hi, my name is Boris, and in this tutorial I'm about to show you how you can synthesize your own snares in Ableton's native operator synthesizer. In fact, what we've got here is a drum rack with four drum elements all synthesized in Ableton's operator, and we've got the kick, hi-hat, clap and snare all modeled after the drum hits from the Roland TR909, and here is what these elements sound like. And in this tutorial, we are only going to talk about this snare, how to synthesize it from scratch and make these cool mappings. And this drum rack is in fact a free download, so if you're interested in having something like this, check it out. It's linked in the video description. And what's so cool about having operators instead of just samples inside the drum rack is that you have much, much more flexibility and control over the core characteristics and timbre of these sounds. So you can tweak the decay, you can tweak all kinds of components that would not be normally possible with just a sample, which most of the time is already processed. This way, if you're synthesizing your own elements, you have maximum control over what you're doing, and you can always process it afterwards yourself. And also, what's so cool about this rack in particular is that these mappings here are done in a way that you can just click randomize and get different sounds. So if I click randomize, we are getting a different snare. Every time we click randomize, we're generating a brand new snare. This is a really cool and very fast way of coming up with different samples on the fly. So I hope after watching this tutorial, you will be able to make your own snares in Operator, and you'll be able to set up racks like this. Before we get into the details, if you like what we are doing, consider subscribing for more Ableton Live tips like this one. We've got a lot more videos coming up, and we've got videos on all the other elements here and much more. So let's open up this instrument rack. So as you can see, this rack consists of two elements, and then we are using a soft clipper to process it as a whole. These two elements are the fundamental, which sounds like this, and the noise. And together they make up a snare. So let's maybe make a brand new MIDI track and just drop a brand new instance of Operator, and we will start from scratch. So a quick introduction to Operator. This is an FM synthesizer, behaves a little bit like Yamaha DX7 from the 80s. This is a bit more of a simplified version, has only four operators. This is really useful for drums in Ableton because this is the synth with the most oscillators, because analog and wavetable, they have only three oscillators. In this case, we are going to have to split it into two instances of operator because we want to just process drastically differently the fundamental, so the attack and the release, which is made of white noise. So you could have technically done the same thing with analog or with wavetable.
Just a quick break before we go back to the tutorial. If you find these type of videos helpful, we can highly recommend the PML Academy with over 35 full-length online courses, spreading over topics like writing chords and melodies or arranging your songs to producing entire songs from start to finish. So check out the link in the description to see what's inside the All Courses bundle exactly.
So let's start from making the fundamental here. Let's go down by an octave and choose a different pitch. So you can choose the pitch yourself here. It doesn't really matter as long as you don't want to have it in tune with your track. And now all we need to do is just bring down the sustain. And we can also bring down the release so that every time we are getting the same length. And now we're just going to use the glue compressor for the soft clipping option. Okay, so we've got this layer, we've got a nice attack that is pitched. We can group this, add another chain and drop another operator here. And this is going to be our noise. So we can use white noise here. Let's drop the sustain down and we can control the decay now. Let's open this sound up with the filter. So we are around 600 milliseconds here. So maybe we can actually also add a gate effect, which would cut a little bit of our tail here, because we are not able to go into linear mode with our envelope, and we don't want the end of the snare to be so long, basically. All we need to do is just go to audio effect, gate, let's bring down the return, and let's shorten the release. Yeah, so now both of these together. I just tweaked the levels here a little bit, and this already starts sounding like a snare. So now we can actually process the white noise as well. We can add some EQ to cut off some of the low end, and maybe we can also cut the highs a little bit. And maybe we can add another glue compressor on top of both of these sounds to do even more soft clipping. That would be pretty much it for the snare. Now we can do some mappings here. So for example, we can map these frequency knobs to the macros. This frequency knob could be going here, and another frequency knob could be going onto the second macro. We could map the decay of the second operator onto the third macro, as well as the release. And also we can control the soft clipping of the fundamental. This would be high pass or low cut. This would be high cut. This would be the decay. And this would be the soft clipping of the fundamental. If you'd like to hit the randomize button like we have in the rack, all you need to do is just limit the ranges of these macros so that you won't get crazy results with like a 20 second decay or so. And this is accessible from this panel when you click map. You can just limit the macro mappings over here. That will be it for this tutorial. Hopefully you can make your own snares like this. You can obviously add a lot of post-processing to make this hit even harder. Thank you guys very much for watching. Consider checking out our Music Production Academy. We've got a lot of start to finish courses on there for both beginners and more advanced producers. Subscribe, hit the notification bell, like and comment if you like this video, and I will see you in the next ones.